Hello, my little DJ Cutie Ruby fans. Hey, just want to show you guys a quick little tour of my art area slash living room. Technically, we are in my living room. Let me see. I might turn on the light here. So this is my living room. It's kind of messy right now. Been sick for like the last week. TV, Howard the dog. This is a TV stand right here. This is where all my art stuff is stacked. You can see some little knickknacks down there, but art stuff, canvases, done art, half done art, some other stuff down here. Some arts and crafts stuff, my camera, my web camera, my other TV dinner tray station where I actually use this one for drawing and filming all my stuff. As you can tell, it's kind of all messy from paint and stuff. I just had nowhere else to put these right now, so see, very messy. I still have to reorganize this area. Luke, the family, me and my family, one of my little ones. My grandmother's bells. I have two grandmothers that passed away in the last 2 years. I think it was 3 years. It was 2013, at the end of 2012. I'm not sure. They need to be cleaned. So, but yeah, this was from my dad's mother. They are just cute little bells. She had tons and tons and tons of bells. And my stepmother sent me these four, which is really cool, even though green is not my favorite color, but each one of them is very, very cool on their own. This one, it's like, looks like the handle looks like a flower vine almost. They need to be cleaned so bad, sorry about that. Like I said, I've been sick. And then the second one is just clear and beautiful, got a little flower on it, very cute. This one doesn't have a dinger, like it doesn't bell, and it's not hollow. This actually piece can come off. And then of course we got this cute little baby one, and it actually says Knott's. Oh, sorry, wrong way. It says Knott's Berry Farm on it, but these are all pretty old. My in-laws did a yard sale, clean up their garage, and I managed to find these really cool little tea set pieces. I don't know what I'm going to do with them exactly yet, but I want to do some kind of project with them. And of course, my mother-in-law gives me like random knickknacks. I have Halloween knickknacks out. I'm going to change this one. This one, I want to change this. I already had to glue his head back on. His head came off. So I'm going to redo the color scheme on this. So skeleton's going to be black. And then the pumpkin's going to be dark purple. And I'll probably leave the pumpkin's eyes the way it is. But look, I put a candle in here. It's a fake candle. A little tea light. But isn't that cute though, guys? Like, imagine if it was dark. It's kind of cute, right? The only thing I think to do with it, though, is to change the colors around a little bit. Got my Unikitty, which is actually a unicorn. But the ears are just so kitty-like that I call it a Unikitty. Oh, I've got my little mannequin for drawing. Oops, that doesn't belong there. My deodorant. just some random pens on my table, and then of course we've got my glossy gel for my paintings. Okay, so this area needs to be redone. I did it a while ago, but of course time goes by. Oh, my laptop, my HP, it's all red and beautiful, red and black. I'm thinking about actually, like, painting on it at some point. This is my makeup case. I do my own makeup downstairs here. Sometimes I do it on camera. It just depends. I keep my three favorite hair things. Little clippies. My famous bow. I've been wearing this bow since, I want to say 2013, 2014. I love it. I wish I had more of them. And then I have two flowers that I wear all the time. I have a blue one somewhere, but I just don't know where it is. But I switch in and out. Oh, I guess you would call this a hair thing too for me. Which I don't have it on, which I should have it on. But it's my little kitty cat ears. Better, right? But yeah, so I keep that stuff here next to me. There's my messiness. This is my real camera. Right now it's missing the battery. I recently got that. If you watch my video, my mail one, I recently got a stand, and I had to fix the bottom because it was really unloose. See that metal thing? I had to put super glue on it to keep the metal screw so that way you could actually not have your camera spinning around the whole time. I need to wait until I have enough money to get the camera up and going. I need to get the battery and the cord. Somehow in the last few years I lost the battery. First, I lost the battery charger, which it was a little plug-in thing. You take the battery out, and then you plug the battery into the charger piece, and then the charger piece into the wall. Between moving to Washington and moving back here, I lost that. So I have no idea where that's at. And then I took the battery out of the camera. My hand's starting to hurt. I took the battery out of the camera at the bottom to go find a new battery. Now I can't find it. But I did look online and I can buy a replacement and I can buy a charger cord. So that'll be good. Please don't judge me. This area is a mess. I have been sick. I'm just fighting the sickness. But I wanted to do another video. I feel like keeping new videos up is going to help build my channel a little bit. So, yeah, we have a few more items that I can share with you right now. I used to have so much more art stuff, but as I said, like, I've moved a lot, so I've lost a lot of it. I remember when I moved to Washington, I lost all my painting stuff. I had tons of brushes, tons of paints, big old canvases, an easel, like a cool tall wooden easel, and I lost that all because I moved. I had nowhere to put it, so I've slowly had to build up my stuff again. This is the beginning of 2017, and that was back in 2012, because my son was born in 2011. It was at the end of 2011. Because we moved to Washington, I want to say it was like November-ish. It was either October or November that we moved to Washington of 2011. And then we spent all 2012 there trying to make it work. And then we moved back in the beginning of 2013, I think it was, maybe. Or 2013. We were definitely back here by 2013. That's all I know. So I've lost a lot of my art stuff. And I'm slowly rebuilding it. Definitely getting a lot more artwork done. It's just some of it back there. But anyway. So on the stack here, this was from my dad for Christmas. This is a cool little art kit that I'm going to definitely try to do something with here shortly. It's got like I want to say, what is it, like 70 some odd pieces in there? I'm afraid to move this stuff because it has a whole bunch of loose stuff. It's got like 24 color pencils, 24 oil pastels, 24 watercolors, 2 drawing pencils, 1 pencil shaver, 2 natural brushes, 1 sanding something, sanding block, and 1 needed eraser. And then there's a pack of brushes for watercolors, oils, or acrylics. I have, this is what I already have. This is about, I want to say this is like 3 different sets of brushes. The blue brushes were 1 set, yellow brushes are another set, and those white brushes are a set I got myself for Christmas, I guess you would say. Haven't used a lot of them yet. The white ones also could be used to do nail art. Sorry. My bad. And then my dad also sent this box right here. This acrylic paint 24 set. It's called the U.S. Art Supply. So that's kind of cool. Here's my PlayStation 4 headset that I hardly ever use anymore. Oh, I love this coloring book. Oh, here's... Okay, so I got these paints. They're like supposedly 3D color paints. I only tried using them 1 time so far and I didn't like the way they came out. But I'm going to try again and see if that time comes out better. I do not know how to say this name. Omimax Colors, or Creators of Color. It came with the white brushes. It says like it's like a 3D, you can use it for like 3D art. It says only for painting, it says. Please do not put this tape. Well, yeah, it says you can use it on your nails or paper or wood or plastic or whatever you want, glass. I used it on watercolor paper. The video might be on here, or I might have to put it on here. I'm not 100% sure. Oh my god, excuse me, I can never get this thing to close though. But yeah, got that for myself with the white brushes. That doesn't shouldn't be there. This is my notebook. This is where I put down like all my ideas and stuff. This page is all about my YouTube videos, transfer Twitch streams, art set test. Yep, see, that's all this stuff right here. Art tour. Oh, doing that right now, guys. Show old drawings. I need to go through all my sketchbooks, and this booklet down here is a binder. Right here, guys. This is from high school. And it's got all kinds of stuff in it. Watercolors, charcoal, pastel, pencil, just different stuff throughout the years. I have a few. This is a watercoloring notebook, regular notebook, mixed media notebooks on here. I built this little thing down here. For paper, that side is for my son because he always wants my paper. This side is all for me. My mother-in-law got me a color book down there. Yeah, I got tons of little things written down for project ideas. More project ideas. Got lots of them everywhere. That's just my writing journal. This is a tin with paint, acrylic paints in it. I actually own 1 oil painting, like 1 oil tube, which is kind of funny, because I thought it was acrylic when I bought it, but I didn't read it very well. I was kind of in a hurry that day, because I was with my mother-in-law, so yeah, not best. And then, of course, I have a whole thing, bigger kit that I've been using of acrylic paint underneath there. This is a fax file folder, basically. So the top of it, though, I've been using for my blenders, This needs to be cleaned out too. Pardon my mess. If you are a fellow artist, you know that sometimes when you get creative, you need to stash your shavings somewhere. And sometimes you don't want to get up. Or you're somewhere where you can't. I have a few good pencils on top. These are not all the pencils I own, though. Right now, my favorite one is this one. Where is it? This is a Graph Gear 500. And it's 0.5 lead. Right now it has red lead in it. But I also have blue lead for it. And you can buy other colored leads. As long as it's the right size, you can put them in. Right now I only have blue and red. But I want to get just regular lead to put in there. We also have some like... I also have my drawing pencils. I don't really do much with these right now because it gets really messy, so I haven't really used those. I've recently started using these to put on the back of my drawings to help me transfer things over to other pieces of paper. I'm not a big fan of it though, like doing that style. I normally just draw the outline on the same piece of paper and just go from there, but I guess a lot of people wouldn't consider that to be a finished piece. I'm not sure, but to me, as long as it all turns out okay, I'm fine. But yeah, so I don't really use these for very much else. Oops. I'll get that later because I'm gonna hurt myself doing that. Reaching down there. Yeah, that's just the top though. Let's close that up. See, like, I got all kinds of stuff in here. I got so much though that it doesn't even fit it all in there. Like, let me move my headset here. This bag is full of markers. It's kind of dirty because it's been down there, but let's see. I use this to travel, so it's got a pencil sharpener. And I need an eraser in here right now. It's got my water brush. It's got one pencil. One black outliner pen. And then it's got, like, three different brands of markers, or two different brands. I think it's just two. Because I don't count my blenders. My blenders are Copic blenders. Oh my god, I love this part of this movie. But, yeah. We've got the, Fine Color markers. And then we have Studio Series Artist markers that are in here. On the floor. This havr. The duck. And Rex, Howard the Duck. Oh! Hi. Sorry, I'm trying to close this back up. I hate these things being open. I'm horrible at this, I know. I love this movie though. It's so funny. I just recently got The Last Unicorn. So I'm hoping next while I'll get this one, Howard the Duck. This is just on TV right now. It's on Outmax. Love it. But yeah, I have all kinds of stuff inside here. We've got sketching pencils. And we got colored pencils. I've got tape. Little folders, got markers in it. It's got like my pen kind of markers in it, I should say. Let's see. Look, he's playing a guitar. It's got my Faber Castell's colorful ones and skin tone ones. This thing right here is a lead holder for the other pencil that was in there. I have three blue, red, and normal lead. These right here, Decorsants. I can't say the name of them either. They're the ones that do this cool effect stuff on top of plastics and stuff. And then I got all my outliners. Then I got sparkly pens. And I do have whiteout pens in here too. I use them for highlights sometimes. Like I said, I got tons of stuff. These are backup markers for the markers that are in here. They are the fine art markers too. Let me see what else we got in here. Oh, we've got my Koi watercolors. Love these. I like the bottom. It's got a little thumb holder so you can hold it on your thumb when you're using it for travel and stuff. Yeah, using it, relearning how to do watercolors. It's kind of cool. It's the one that came with the little water brush that I had in the other thing. So normally the water brush goes in here. I lost the black thing that goes that keeps the water from coming out, so it just stays put together. But yeah, like I've been using it. Can you tell? Those are two sponges, one on each side. The palette thing comes off. You can stick it over here on this side, or you can stick it on this side to add more room. But yeah, I have that. It's really cool. I like it. But I don't travel with it much. I just do it at home. I have more watercolors inside the little tin. We're going to go through a more thorough one of these little things at another point. But, and here's like all my older color pencils. And oh my god, I love these ones. The General's Pastel Chalk pencils. They have erasers on the bottom. In high school, I used them a lot. I have a bunch of landscape ones that I've done with those from back in high school. I have watercolor pencils in the stack. And then just other regular color pencils. They just say supply on them. Simply color. Oh my. So like I said, this one is just backup markers to what was in the case that I already opened up for you guys. And then I also have these. I don't know how to turn the light on in my phone. Okay, so anyway, I have these two Perfect Pearls Mists. They are really cool. I've used them on a few pieces already. You just kind of shake them up, and there's a little ball inside. And then you just kind of lightly mist them onto whatever you want. Or you can actually put them on a brush. I would prefer if you did that method, that you use a brush that you're not technically using for paintings probably ever again. Only because it kind of like gets the paintbrush a little gunky and a little sticky. But yeah. And if you're not careful, it will spray all over everything, including my phone at one point, and all over that little table that I showed earlier. So yeah. I have two of these, one in Perfect Pearl, and the other is Heirloom Gold. Haven't used them too much, only on a few pieces. The sprayers do kind of get stuck though. So yeah. Okay, what else we got? My tape. It's Duck brand tape. It's just really simple to come off of things. No big deal. This is another. This has Touch Crew markers in it. I think it has some other kind of marker in it too. Okay. Yeah, it has a Touch markers, which are the white ones. And then it has my Prismacolor markers in it as well. I have a little bit of different brands. I don't have, like, every color and every kind of brand there is. Just kind of a little bit of this, a little bit of that right now. And I'm learning to use the markers slowly but surely, just like I am with my paintings. Most of my stuff, though, turns out to be multimedia, which it has, like, different stuff, like colored pencil, marker. Let me see what else we got in here. Oh, my little hand gloves for my hands when they hurt. Due to my fibromyalgia, hands do tend to hurt. I have a glue stick down in there. Big one down there. More drawing pencils. Old markers, just regular Corolla markers. Sharpies. Believe it or not, I used to work with Bic Market fine point permanent markers. Like, these were how a lot of my stuff used to get colored in with marker until I got my other markers. I do have a few of the Spectrum Aqua markers. I like these ones. They have brush, like a brush tip on one end and like a really, really small fine tip. Let me see. I can't get this lid to stay up right now. Oh, one of my first markers ever were these. Letterista Pro markers. They were like, my first set ever of like really cool markers. So yeah, that's really what I got in here. I have a ruler in here. Hardly ever used it. Some swatch paper. Just some random thing I kept for my daughter's hair thing. But yeah. This is kind of like my little art area. Have some notepads over there stacked up. Like I said, I'm going to reorganize all this stuff. And when I do, I will do another little tour. But I've been sick and I haven't done any of those things lately. But yeah. So that's what I got. No, oh, right over there. My son's artwork right over there on top of all our games. He's trying to take after mommy, can you tell? So yeah, that's all my stuff. And I hope to have another cool video for you guys later on after this weekend or during this weekend again. Not sure exactly what I'm going to go to. I'm kind of feeling a little better, but not fully better. If that makes any sense at all. It's mostly just like in the throat. So, I really hope to have more videos for you guys. I hope you guys enjoy watching them. Gotten a few comments lately on them. I have a friend that I guess has been watching them to stay in touch with me. Which is really cool. I appreciate that. You know who you are. If you guys ever have any questions, we can also try to do a question video. Q&A, maybe. Yeah, I've got some really cool art plans coming up. I have one where I'm going to be using the stuff my dad sent for Christmas. My dad and my stepmom. Obviously, I probably won't be able to use... I might not be able to use them all on the same piece. But I do have acrylic paint and watercolor paint and pastels and colored pencils and all kinds of different stuff. But I might be able to make it into a whole piece. It might be in two. Not sure yet. And then after that, my husband has a challenge for me to do. He wants me to do a freehand painting without pre-drawing it on a paper or canvas first. The rules are I can come up with a piece, which I kind of have already, but I can't pre-draw it out or really technically plan it out until I start putting the paint down on the canvas. I'm not really sure what is with him and trying to get me to do these things. He says it's to broaden my horizon. He's not even an artsy person at all, but he definitely into challenging me. Definitely into challenging me. I'm more into like cutesy, fun, cartoony style stuff nowadays. He wants me to try to go back into landscape stuff, which I wasn't even that great at doing back then, and I did it with mostly colored pencil back then, and those pastel charcoal pencils that I showed you guys. A lot of them were done in high school, and they weren't really that good. But I'm trying. So I'm thinking I'll take him up on his challenge. I still haven't done any of those marker challenges yet, which I'm going to. I'm going to do the one marker challenge. I want to do a two marker challenge. I want to do a three marker challenge. I want to, like, you know, I want to do, like, a bunch of different challenges. I want to do all kinds of different stuff. My channel is a smorgasbord of different things: gaming, eating, talking, vlogging, art, just whatever. I don't like being stuck in one category, I guess. So for me, the category thing is just not working out for me, and I don't want to have a different channel for every different thing that I like to do. So, because that's just like too much work. It is. It's too much work. So, those are my plans. You just saw my miniature little art area. It's not very big. It is just part of my living room. I just do my stuff on these little tables here. My computer sits on one. And then I normally bring that one that's over there. Ooh. I bring it over here to where this footstool is right here. And I do my art normally right here in this chair, which can be a little difficult. Posture, back support is a no-go. I would like to get a new chair. Like a big, like a, you know, one of those really good gaming chairs. Maybe put a massager thing on the back of it. That would be really cool, but I don't really have the funds for those kind of things right now. But maybe one day. Maybe one day. That'd be really cool. And a better desk, a better setup. That'd be all really cool too. We don't have an extra room in our house. Because we have three kids, and one has the tiniest room ever. And then the two boys share a room, and then me and my husband have a room. We have a basement where my kids play downstairs and have a lot of their toys downstairs. And then so yeah, this is like the limited space right over here. This is my little nook. It works because I do a lot of good pieces here. I did that piece here in this chair. I did both those pieces that are hanging over there in this chair. A bunch of my pieces I've done in this area with this chair and stuff. So it's not all that bad. Uh-oh. Whoa. Yuck. Hard sneezing. But yeah, that is just, this is my area. And I hope you guys enjoyed this little video. And, you know, every time I have a video, you guys get to see more and more of the real me. And that's awesome, and I am so happy that you guys are here with me and hanging out with me. And if you have friends that would like to see someone like me, then share me around. I don't really care. Have a good night, guys.